In this video, we're continuing on with the Solving Multi-Step Equations worksheet under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. So our goal in solving multi-step equations is to isolate the variable so that we can figure out the value that the variable is equal to. And in number 9, we're going to start by distributing the 6. We're distributing that to the negative x and to the 3 with subtraction in between. So we're going to have 24 equal to 6 times negative x minus 6 times 3. That'll be 24 equal to 6 times negative x, which is negative 6x, minus 6 times 3, which is 18. Now, in order to solve for x, we need to get the term with x all by itself. In order to do that, we're going to add 18 to both sides. 24 plus 18 will give us a positive 42, and that's going to be equal to negative 6x. Now, we just need to isolate this x. And in order to do that, we're going to divide by negative 6. When we divide both sides by negative 6, we get that 42 divided by negative 6 is equal to a negative 7, and that's equal to x. So negative 7 is our solution in number 9. In number 10, we're going to be distributing the 3. We're distributing that to the negative 6n and to the 5 with subtraction in between each of those terms. So we'll have 75 equal to 3 times negative 6n minus 3 times 5. 75 is going to be equal to 3 times negative 6n is negative 18n, and we're subtracting 3 times 5, which is 15. Now remember, we want to get this term with the n all by itself, so we're going to start by adding 15 to both sides. 75 plus 15 will give us a positive 90, and that's going to be equal to negative 18n, since negative 15 plus 15 is 0. Our next step is to divide by negative 18 to isolate that n. 90 divided by negative 18 is a negative 5. So negative 5 is equal to n in number 10. On to the second page, number 11. For number 11, we're going to start by distributing this negative 3. It gets multiplied to 1, and it gets multiplied to 6r with addition in between. So negative 3 times 1 is negative 3, and we're adding that to negative 3 times 6r, which is negative 18r, and that's equal to 14 minus r. Now we want all our terms with r on the same side of the equation. So I'm going to add 18r to both the left and the right. When I do this, I'll have negative 3 left on the left-hand side, and that's going to be equal to 14 minus r plus 18r. So this is like negative 1r plus 18r, which will be a positive 17r. Now my next step, in order to isolate the term with r, in this case it's 17r, I'm going to subtract 14 from both sides. Negative 3 minus 14 is negative 17, and that's equal to positive 17r. Rewriting that up here, negative 17 is equal to positive 17r. My final step is to divide both sides by 17. Negative 17 divided by a positive 17 will give me negative 1, and that's going to be equal to r. So negative 1 is my solution in number 11. In number 12, I'm going to start by distributing the 6. 6 times 6v is going to be 36v, and we're adding that, so plus 6 times 6, which is 36. Then we're subtracting 5, and that is all equal to 1 plus 6v. I'm going to combine like terms on the left-hand side. So I'm going to have 36v plus 36 minus 5, which is going to be 31, and that's equal to 1 plus 6v. Now in this case, I want my terms with v on my left-hand side and all other terms on my right-hand side. So I'm going to do that all in one step. I'm going to subtract by 6v on both sides to move my terms with v all to the left. And I'm also going to subtract 31 from both sides to move my term without v to the right. 36v minus 6v will be 30v, and that's going to be equal to 1 minus 31, which is negative 30. My final step is to divide both sides by 30 to get that v is equal to negative 30 divided by 30, which is a negative 1. So my solution in number 12 is negative 1. In number 13, I'll start by distributing this positive 2. So I'll have negative 4k plus 2 times 5k is 10k minus 2 times 6, which is 12, and that's equal to negative 3k minus 39. Combining like turns on my left, I'll combine negative 4k with 10k. Negative 4k plus 10k is a positive 6k, and then we're subtracting 12, and that's equal to negative 3k minus 39. Again, I'm going to move all my terms with my variable to the left-hand side of my equation and all other terms to the right. So I'm going to add a positive 3k to both sides, and I'm going to add 12 to both sides. So you can see my 12s will cancel out and my 3k's will cancel out. So I'm left with my terms with k on my left and my terms without k on my right. 6k plus 3k is 9k, and that's equal to negative 39 plus 12, which is a negative 27. When I divide both sides by 9, I get that k is equal to negative 3, since negative 27 divided by 9 is a negative 3. So negative 3 is my solution in number 13. Now on to number 14. I'm going to distribute that negative 7 with addition in between. And while I'm at it, I'll go ahead and subtract 3 from both sides. Negative 16 minus 3 gives me negative 19. We're adding that to 5 in, and then that's equal to negative 7 times negative 6, which is a positive 42, plus negative 7 times 8 in, which is negative 56 in. And we already took care of the 3. In this case, I'm going to move all my terms with a variable to the right-hand side, so I'm going to start by subtracting 5 in. 5 in minus 5 in is 0, so I'll have negative 19. On my left-hand side, that will be equal to 42 plus negative 56 minus 5 in is negative 61 in. Next, I'll subtract 42 from both sides in order to isolate that term with the n. Negative 19 minus 42 will give me negative 61, and that's equal to 42 minus 42, which is 0, plus negative 61 n, which is negative 61 n. My final step is to divide both sides by negative 61. Negative 61 divided by negative 61 equals a positive 1, so 1 is equal to n in number 14. And I'll stop the video here. Continue on in the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet, completing numbers 15 through 21. And as always, all likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, so feel free to do that now.